Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the .NET MAUI Linear Gauge control. In general, linear gauge are used for visualizing numeric measurements in a horizontal or vertical scale. It usually has one or more pointers to indicate specific values on a scale. Before proceeding, make sure that you have one of the following .NET SDKs installed in your machine. You should also have Visual Studio 2022 installed with the required .NET MAUI workloads. With that confirmed, let's start building an app. I open Visual Studio 2022 and create a new project from the project dashboard. From the list of project templates, I choose .NET MAUI app and name my project Gauge Example. After that, I will continue with default .NET 7 framework and click Create to complete the project creation. Now, my default application has been created and is ready to use. Next, let's see the application's default output. Before running it, I choose the Android emulator from this list to see the output in the Pixel 5 emulator. The application compiles a default code, so let's wait. Look here, my .NET MAUI application shows the default output. Now, let me show you the steps to display linear gauge control here. First, I need to install the Syncfusion.NET MAUI Gauges NuGet package. So, I stop the debugging and open the NuGet package manager. In the Browse tab, I search for the Syncfusion.NET MAUI Gauges package and install it in my project. Click OK to continue the installation. It takes a few seconds to complete the installation, so let's wait. Okay, let's start to initialize the linear gauge control. Before that, I need to register the Syncfusion.NET MAUI trial license key. I open this app XAML CS file and register the trial license key using the register license method. To see where to generate this trial key, refer to the link in the description below. Now, I will proceed to initialize the control. First, I open this main.xaml page and remove the default content from the content page section. In this page, I import the Syncfusion MAUI gauge control namespace. And I include the .NET MAUI linear gauge control. Then, I need to register the handler for Syncfusion Core to map the cross-platform control API to the native view API. So, open the MAUI program file and add the Syncfusion MAUI Core hosting namespace. Then, I register the Syncfusion Core handler by making a call to the method configure Syncfusion Core. Okay, everything needed for rendering the control is configured. I save the changes and run this application. You can see the linear gauge displayed with default elements like axis line, labels, and ticks. Note that, by default, the gauge is rendered in a horizontal direction, but you can also display it vertically using the orientation property. To do that, navigate to the main.xaml page and define the orientation property with value vertical. Check now, the linear gauge is displayed in a vertical direction. Here, I am planning to render the gauge at the center of the page with a custom height. So, I add the height request property and set its value to 500 pixels. Then, I will define the horizontal options property with the value center to display the gauge at the center. You can see the linear gauge displayed at the center of the page with a custom height. In case I want to show scale values between 10 and 130, then set minimum property value to 10 and maximum value to 130. Also, I will set the interval property to 20 to display the gauge labels at this defined interval. Look here, the linear gauge is displayed with custom scale values between 10 and 130, and the labels are shown at the interval of 20. Next, I will proceed to show how to customize the linear scale track. The linear gauge provides the following built-in options to customize the linear scale track. From these options, I am going to use fill and thickness properties to set custom color and width. First, I will add the line style property and define the linear line style tag. Then, add the fill option with custom color and set thickness property to 12. See the gauge, the linear scale track is shown in blue color with a defined thickness. As you know, I have set solid color for the scale track using fill property. But, you can also customize them by applying gradient colors. Check the gauge scale values, it is shown from bottom to top. Suppose, I want to show them from top to bottom. Then define the isInversed property and set its value to true. As you can see, the linear scale values are shown from top to bottom. Okay, next let's see how to add pointers to a linear gauge. The linear gauge control has three different types of pointers like bar, shape, and content. Here, I am going to set a shape pointer, so add the markers pointer tag, and then the linear shape pointer tag. And set the value property to 70 to display pointer at that value. Look at the linear gauge now, it displays the pointer pointed to 70. Next, let's see how to customize the shape pointer. To display the pointer with custom color and size, I define the fill property as red and set the shape height and width to 25 pixels. Check the gauge now, the pointer is shown in red color with custom size. Apart from these options, you can also customize the border, marker alignment, position, and offset. Also, notice here, the pointer shown in the gauge is static. Suppose, I want to animate them, I make use of these animation properties. To do that, I simply need to add the enable animation property and set its value to true inside the shape pointer tag. See the pointer with animation effect. Notice here, the pointer moves from the start value to the defined pointer value continuously. If I want to specify the interval between snap points when the pointer moves, I set the custom value to 8 in the step frequency property. Check now, the pointer moves at the interval of 8. The default animation type is linear, but you can animate the pointer with different animation types like bounce in, cubic out, spring in, and many more. From these, I am going to use bounce out animation type. Let me define the animation easing property with the static type, bounce out. The shape pointer is animated using the defined animation type. Now, I will show you how to set a range for the scale track. To do that, first, I define the ranges tag, which accepts n number of linear range definitions. As I am going to add a single range, so define a linear range tag and set the start value and end value properties with the values 10 and 53 respectively. Look at the linear gauge now, the range is between values 10 and 53 on the axis track. Next, I will show you how to add multiple ranges to the linear gauge and differentiate them with colors. I plan to add two more ranges to the axis track. I define two more linear range tags with the start value and end value properties. As I'd set the first range between 10 and 53, so, I have set the second range from 53 to 83, and 83 to 130 for the third range. Also, I am going to display the ranges in cross position with different colors. So, for these linear range tags, I add the fill and position properties with appropriate values. Here, the position is set to cross, but you can also position the ranges either inside or outside the track. To display the range clearly, let me remove the line styles applied here. See now, the newly added ranges are shown with different colors. For these ranges, I have applied a solid color. But, you can also apply gradient colors using the gradient stops property. By default, ticks and labels in the gauge are positioned inside the gauge track. To position them outside the track, define the tick and label position with the value outside. See the linear gauge now, the tick lines and labels are positioned outside the track. Okay, next let's see how to customize the gauge labels. You can customize the labels by using the properties like text color, font attributes, font family, and font size. Here, I am planning to display labels in bold with different color. So add the gauge label style tag inside the label style tag. And define the text color and font attributes properties with appropriate values. Then, I also set the pointer position to cross to display the pointer at the center. The labels are shown in bold with blue color. Note here, by default, numeric values are shown in the labels. But, you can also display the customized text labels. Say for example, in degrees Celsius, I use the format property. First, I define the label format property and set a label value with an additional suffix, degrees Celsius. You can now see the linear gauge labels displaying the values in degrees Celsius format. Now, let me make a quick recap of what I have shown so far. You saw how to create a MAUI project using Visual Studio 2022 and add a Syncfusion MAUI linear gauge control to it. I also showed you how to add an axis pointer and change the position of ticks and labels. Finally, I showed you how to add multiple ranges to an axis and format the labels. If you would like to see the working of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link, which is shared in the description part below. You can also grab your chance of getting a free license key to use our complete MAUI products if you fit into our community guidelines. So, check the link given in the description part to know if you are eligible for using our community license. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching this video.